Hi, good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Lord's Day Sunday. Today we're doing the last and eight and final P of a Christian, of the eight P's of a Christian miniseries. Today we're going to be talking about partnership. The partnership of a Christian. Your Lord's Day Sunday, December 12, 2021. 13 days till Christmas. Days till the end of the year. And 7 weeks until episode 600. Sorry about that. But if you're excited about this eighth and final P of a Christian, smash that like button. Comment what's been your favorite P of a Christian. Sorry about that. Had a real quick pause. Sorry about that. But today we're going to be, is episode 564, part 1. 65. Excuse me. Sorry about that. 64 was yesterday. 65 is today. It's part 1 of episode 565. Today we're going to be starting with Ephesians 2:19. So, subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends and help me reach that goal of 100 subscribers by January 15th. If I've already said that, I'm sorry. But without further ado, let's see what this eighth and final P of a Christian is all about. Partnership. It is titled The Christian's Partnership. That's how all of this is titled, saying The Christians, whatever. So as we started out, let me go do a real quick rundown, and I'll do a real quick rundown at the end. Last Sunday we started it. We were talking about the Christian's position. I'm just going to read it like the title says. Then Monday we talked about the Christian's purpose. Tuesday we talked about the Christian's prosperity. Wednesday we talked about the Christian's permission. Then Thursday we talked about the Christian's possibilities. Then Friday we talked about the Christian's power. And then yesterday we talked about the Christian's parentage. Well, you know it was yesterday, but I know it was just a little while ago that I went through Christian's parentage. There's two videos prior to this one that I recorded with that one, because I only done two videos for Saturday, so now I'm on the third video of this little small recording session here on Friday evening. But we talked about the Christian's parentage yesterday, and today we talk about the Christian's partnership. So let's see what happens in store. Ephesians 2:19. Now therefore ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God. Excuse me. Sorry about that. So prior to salvation, we are called aliens and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now we are part of the new man, and the grand partnership has been made possible between Jew and Gentile, old and new covenant saints, and the operative impact and purpose of the household of God. Ephesians 2, 12 and 13, 15 and 19 is where most of those phrases are coming from. Aliens and strangers, when we started that one, that was 12 and 13. The new man comes from 15, and the household of God is 19. Most of the verses they put on here are in the quotation marks. So you know that's the verse. So that's why I was going through the phrases that were with the quotation marks. So now we are made nigh and made one. The enemy has been abolished with the middle wall of partition that was between us broken down. Verses 13 through 15. Making us one body with common access by one spirit unto the Father. Verses 16 through 18. Therefore, we are fellow citizens with the saints of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, fitly framed, going unto a holy temple for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Verses 19 through 22. Now displayed in the fellowship of past and present, bond and free, male and female, all new partakers of his promise in Christ by the gospel. Ephesians 3, 1 through 6, and Galatians 3, 22 through 29. And God has created all things by Jesus Christ to the intent that now unto the principalities and powers in heavenly places might be known by the church the manifold wisdom of God according to the eternal purpose which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Verses 9 through 11. And I guess that would be Galatians. Either it's Galatians 3 or it's Ephesians 3. I don't know. I want to make sure. Let's go to Ephesians 3 first. Yeah, Ephesians. Ephesians 3, what? Let's try 3:9. And to make all see what is the fellowship of the mystery which was beginning of the ages, have been hidden God who created all things through Jesus Christ. It's Ephesians. The Ephesians, where it says, the last one said Ephesians 3, 1 through 6, then that jumps down to 9 through 11. Okay. So God has designed his salvation for us in such a way that we cannot fail to achieve his plans for us. And we should humbly thank him for what he has accomplished in us through Christ Jesus. Amen? And there you have it. The eighth and final P of a Christian. Partnership. So, I'll run through it one more time. If you missed it at the beginning. Last Sunday, we started this 8 P's of a Christian. We started out with the Christian's position. Position. Next, we went through, on Monday, we went through the Christian's purpose. Tuesday, we went through the Christian's prosperity. Wednesday, we talked about the Christian's permission. Thursday, we talked about the Christian's possibilities. Friday, we talked about the Christian's power. See the twin P words? Yesterday, we talked about the Christian's parentage. And then today, we talked about the Christian's partnership. So, position, purpose. Prosperity, permission, possibilities, power, parentage, and partnership. All 8 of those. That's all I have for that today. Coming up in another Fantastic Monday, episode 566 part one, we're going to be talking about the name of David. Oh, wait a minute. That's going to be another. It's going to be the next video of the series. So that would be episode, that would be video number 47 of the series. The next one was 47. So that would be number 47 of the miniseries. Of the series. Sorry, I don't know why I say miniseries. I get so used to saying miniseries that I just can't get out of saying just series. So we're going to be talking about the name of David in number 47 of the series. And we're going to start with 2 Samuel 23, verses 1 and 2. Stay tuned to that. I'll get that in just a couple days. Probably sometime today I'll get to it. IRL. It's just still Fridays. But coming up in your afternoon video for this Lord's Day Sunday, we're going to be in part two. We're going to be talking about Heroes, Tyrants, and Jesus from Mart, M-A-R-T, Dehaan, D-E-H-A-A-N. And it comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 1 through 10. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But you'll see that. 1 o'clock, 1:30, 2 o'clock, whatever I decide to put, whatever. I think it's going to be about 1:30. Because the morning one goes up at 8, so it went live at 8, or public at 8. So you got 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. I tried to do it about 6 hours. So I'm basically going to say 1:30, so that's what time it will show up. So, and I thought I would get out before 10 on this one. I'm sorry. But I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned for part two. And I'll see you then. But keep on keeping on and trusting God. And He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day Sunday morning. Come back again later. Later this afternoon for part two, Heroes, Tyrants, and Jesus. And we'll see what that's all about. I'll see that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later today. So, but up until then, I'll see you then. Goodbye.